Good morning to everyone. Myself, N. Kalpna. I'm from Sri G.k.jain Higher Secondary School, Royapuram. For more educational video, please subscribe our YouTube channel.
Today, for the 10th standard, I'm going to explain the lessons plant and animal hormone. In the previous video, we discussed about the pituitary gland and the types of lobes. It is the anterior as well as the posterior lobe. And in the anterior lobe, what are all the different types of hormone which is present in the anterior lobe? Anterior lobe is a lobe means which is nothing else. It should be present in the front portion. Posterior means the lobe which is being present near the back portion. In the anterior lobe, first it has been started with the growth hormone. The growth hormone will be helpful both. It should be helpful for the growth only. Okay. If it has been deficiency, if it is not being secreted properly, means it is also leads to a disease like dwarfism, gigantism, and acromegaly. And next one, it is a thyroid stimulating hormone which is being helpful for the thyroid hormones. And next one, it is a adrenocatechotropic hormone, ATH, which is being secreted near the kidney and it is being helpful for the synthesis of protein also. The protein is very important for the growth, so it is being very important. And next one, it is about the gonadotropic hormone. The gonadotropic hormone means which is being responsible for the reproductive organs. So it is being for the both the male as well as the female. Again, it is being classified into FSH as well as the LH. FSH means follicle stimulating hormone and LH means luteinizing hormone. So in the male, it is for the testosterone is a hormone. Only one hormone will be present for the male. And the female, it has been having a two kinds of hormone. One is the estrogen as well as the progesterone. Why it has been compared with the male and female? Here the male having only both, they are the living being. But male having only one hormone and the female having a two hormone. Because we know that the woman is having the a great tendency for the a great specialist for the giving its young one, isn't it? The childbirth is a very important for the female. That is why she is having, they having a two different kinds of hormones. One is the estrogen, other one is the progesterone. Estrogen means before the pregnancy, when it is being started with the child in the stage of infant, up to that, before the pregnancy stage, that hormone will be the estrogen hormone, which is being responsible for the growth and all. And after the childbirth, because after the birth, she has been facing a lot of difference in her body condition. Because of these hormonal changes, because she needs the feeding to the young one, as well as the, her structure is also being different. That is why, because of these hormonal difference, isn't it? So before pregnancy, before the childbirth, the woman having the female having the estrogen hormones. Then after pregnancy, after the childbirth, she has been having a different hormone, that is the progesterone. Okay, that is the thing. And next one, it is about the prolactin. So it has been shortly we have described as a P or L. Okay, these are all the short terms, which is very important. What is it? GH, TSH, ATH, ATH, as well as the FH. For the follicle stimulating, it is a FH. And luteinizing hormone, it is a LH. Okay. And GTH, last one is the prolactin. So this is a hormone. For what it is being the prolactin means, it is for the mammary gland. After the childbirth, the female having the in the mammary gland, a kind of liquid, that means a milk, has been secreted. For secretion of milk, for the feeding of a child, it needed what type of hormones it is being needed? It is a prolactin hormone. So far, this is about the anterior lobe. In the anterior lobes, it has been classified as a 5 major types. And next we discuss about the posterior lobes. So where are the locations of posterior lobe? It is being located at the back side of the lobes. Two lobes are being present. The front lobe will be the anterior lobe and the back lobe will be the posterior lobe. The posterior lobe, which is otherwise called as a neurohypophysis, the other name which is very important. And the posterior lobe, it is being divided into two ways. One is the vasopressin. Why the diuretic will be necessary? Because if there is a frequent urination, means they have been losing their water capacity also, as well as some kind of minerals will be there. So that is why these hormones will be helpful for the diuretic purpose. But if the diabetic patient, means they have been deficiency of vasopressin, because they will be in a diuretic way. So when the kidney, if you say the kidney, first of all what happened, the kidney have been absorbed the all unwanted materials from the other parts of the body towards it, okay. And next one, from that it started to reabsorbing the water content, then the remaining one, it is being sent it out, it will be excreted. If the reabsorption is not being held, means that person which is being leading to the dehydration. So the kidney play a vital role for the excretion as well as the dehydration. So these hormones will be helpful for that. It is a vasopressin, as otherwise called it as a diuretic. And next one, it is a very very important one. It is the oxytocin. So oxytocin, we already discussed here for the prolactin. What type of hormone will be present after a childbirth? It is a progesterone will be there and prolactin will be there. There are different kinds of hormone. She is always having a 7 glands will be there. It is common for that. Extra one, it is a prolactin hormone will be secreted for the feeding one. And next one, it is progesterone has been secreted, as well as it is the oxytocin is a very important one. Why the oxytocin? What is the purpose? The oxytocin will be helpful for the smoothening of muscle as well as the contraction process. Why the contraction process will be helped? If the child will be in the uterus form, okay, before the child, but the child will be in the uterus. So when after the growth, it has been after maturation, the child has been get out from the, it has been get away from the uterus, okay. That is during the delivery time. You already know about the two kinds of delivery. One is the normal, other one is C-section or cesarean, okay. So normal delivery means the contraction has been done. After the contraction only, it has been done by the normal delivery. So for that normal delivery, for that contraction, the oxytocin is a very important one. So it is what it has been held, already the muscles have been smoothed. So after when the female, it has been reached the delivery stage, means the muscle has to start and it's smoothed. Then only the baby can be get away from the uterus, isn't it? So the muscles have been very smoothed in way. These hormones will be helpful for the contractions of the uterus. If the contractions will be held, contraction means it will be shrink, okay, it has been reduced its size, that is called as a contraction. So if the contractions will be held, automatically the child, the baby will be come out smoothly from the things. So if you seeing the things, all the process in your body started from the respiratory, reproduction, excretion, inhalation, digestion, all those things, we need the hormone. That is why it is a very important thing. It is a, the glands is a very important thing, isn't it? Then, because the glands only, the hormones have been secreted in the glands only. We can see the two, only in the session we have seen only the pituitary glands. Of these pituitary glands, how many hormones are there? So it shows that much of difference in them. Especially for the female, they have been, it has been relatively 5 hormones. Comparatively, the child, the male and the female, she will be having a more than 2 extra hormones she will be there. So the hormone play a vital role for the physiological activity. So it has to be secreted in a normal way. We have to maintain it. While taking a normal diet, healthy foods, we have to maintain it in a normal way. If it has been improper, what is the meaning of improper? Both the conditions we have to explain. Both the extent we have to say. One, it is about the hyper condition, one other one is a hyper condition. If it has been extracted, secreted in a larger way, that too also it has been leading to the some kind of diseases like gigantism, acromegaly and all. If it is being secreted in a hyper condition, that too also it has created a deficient. So what we have to do, we have to maintain a balanced way of the hormonal zone. So hormones play a vital role. It has been secreted in a balanced way. We don't get into the improper way. That is why if you seeing the child from the childhood to the adolescent, it will be showing a lot of differences, isn't it? After reaching, a person after reaching the adolescent, she will be facing a lot of imbalanced way. In psychology, we call it as a swing mode, isn't it?
Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.